In the words of the legendary George S. Patton, accept the challenges so that you can feel the exhilaration of victory. Born in the year 1885, George Smith Patton Jr. was destined to become a warrior. Raised in a family with a rich military heritage, Patton's fascination with the art of war was sparked at an early age. He would listen wide-eyed to tales of valor and bravery from his father, himself a veteran. As a child, Patton was not just intrigued by the military, he was captivated by it. He spent countless hours studying military history, engrossing himself in the tactics and strategies of great battles past. His childhood was steeped in the lore of ancient warriors and epic conflicts, a foundation that would serve him well in the years to come. Patton's early years were a foreshadowing of the remarkable military career that was to come. His journey from a young boy with an insatiable curiosity about war to one of the most respected and feared generals of World War II is a tale of ambition, determination, and unwavering courage. From the very beginning, Patton was destined for greatness. His journey began at the esteemed Virginia Military Institute, where he spent a year honing his military skills and developing his leadership capabilities. It was here that he began to show signs of the exceptional leader he would become. His dedication to duty, his unwavering commitment to excellence, and his ability to inspire those around him were all evident during this time. After a year at the Virginia Military Institute, Patton moved on to the United States Military Academy at West Point. The academy, known for its rigorous academic and physical training, was the perfect environment for Patton to further develop his leadership skills and military acumen. Patton immersed himself in his studies, showing a particular interest in history and fencing. His focus and tenacity earned him recognition from his professors and peers alike. Patton graduated from West Point in the top half of his class, a testament to his hard work and dedication. His academic achievements, coupled with his impressive physical abilities, led to his commission as a second lieutenant in the cavalry. This was a significant accomplishment, as the cavalry was considered one of the most prestigious branches of the military at the time. But Patton's time at West Point wasn't just about academics and physical training, it was also about developing the leadership qualities that would define his military career. He learned the importance of strategic thinking, quick decision-making, and the ability to inspire and lead his troops. He developed a reputation for being a tough but fair leader, someone who demanded the best from his soldiers, but was also willing to lead by example. Patton's time at West Point laid the foundation for his future success. It was here that he learned the skills and developed the qualities that would serve him well throughout his distinguished military career. From cadet to general, Patton's journey was marked by perseverance, dedication, and a relentless pursuit of excellence. His time at West Point was a pivotal chapter in the making of a leader, a chapter that set the stage for the remarkable achievements that were yet to come. Patton's first taste of battle came during the Pancho Villa expedition. In 1916, the United States embarked on a mission to capture the notorious Mexican revolutionary, Pancho Villa. Among the greenhorns was a young officer named George S. Patton. This was Patton's first real combat experience, and it was here that he began to shine as a military strategist. Patton's role in the expedition was initially administrative, but he yearned for more. He sought out opportunities to demonstrate his tactical acumen and courage. Soon, his talent was recognized, and he was given command of a custom-built unit of armored vehicles, an innovative concept at the time. Patton's leadership during the expedition was marked by a relentless pursuit of objectives and an unyielding spirit. His first significant action came when he led a daring raid on a ranch in San Miguelito. Patton, along with 10 soldiers, executed a well-planned and brilliantly coordinated attack, resulting in the capture of three of Villa's top lieutenants. This successful operation catapulted Patton into the limelight and earned him the nickname Bandito from his fellow soldiers. What's remarkable is that Patton didn't just lead from the back. He was known to be right in the thick of things, demonstrating a level of bravery that was both inspiring and infectious. He was not just a leader, he was a soldier's soldier. Patton's experience during the Pancho Villa expedition proved instrumental in shaping his military career. It honed his strategic thinking, nurtured his leadership abilities, and steeled his resolve for the battles to come. Most importantly, it cemented his belief in the power of armored warfare, a concept he would later champion and refine during the World Wars. In the dusty plains of Mexico, a young George S. Patton tasted his first battle. He demonstrated a unique blend of courage, strategic acumen, and relentless determination. It was clear even then that he was destined for great things in the theater of war. This was just the beginning of Patton's illustrious battlefield career. World War I marked a turning point in Patton's career. As the world descended into chaos, this determined officer found his calling within the ironclad walls of a new invention: the tank. Patton's introduction to the tank was a chance encounter, but he quickly saw its potential. He understood that this mechanized beast could change the face of warfare. With this belief, he embarked on a mission. His goal? To create the U.S. Tank Corps, a force that could wield these metal monsters with deadly precision. With relentless dedication, Patton molded the U.S. Tank Corps from a ragtag group of soldiers into a formidable force. He didn't just command from the rear, no, Patton led from the front, a beacon of courage under fire. His leadership was not just about barked orders and strict discipline, it was about instilling a spirit of fearlessness, a tenacity to fight, and an unyielding will to win. In the brutal fields of France, Patton's Tank Corps debuted. His innovative strategies took the enemy by surprise. The tanks under Patton's command moved with a speed and ferocity that the enemy had never seen before. They shattered defensive lines, wreaked havoc on supply routes, and sowed confusion in the heart of the enemy. Patton's tactics in World War I were revolutionary. He dared to think differently, to challenge the traditional norms of warfare. His strategies were not just about brute force. They were about using speed, surprise, and the unique capabilities of the tank to outmaneuver the enemy, to hit them where they least expected, and to keep them on the back foot. Patton's performance in World War I was a testament to his leadership, his strategic acumen, and his unwavering courage. He had taken a new weapon, the tank, and turned it into a game changer on the battlefield. His success in this great war solidified his place as a rising star in the U.S. military. It was a glimpse of the greatness that was yet to come. Patton's performance in World War I solidified his place as a rising star in the U.S. military. In World War II, Patton truly made his mark. This was the stage where he shone the brightest, demonstrating strategic brilliance and unyielding determination that left an indelible imprint in history. In the Mediterranean, General Patton took command of the 7th Army. He was instrumental in the successful invasion of Sicily in July of 1943, a campaign that was marked by his swift and decisive actions. He understood that speed was of the essence, spearheading a lightning-fast advance that left the enemy reeling. But Patton's true genius was not confined to the Mediterranean. He was soon given command of the 3rd Army, leading them across France and into Germany. His rapid, audacious maneuvers often took the enemy by surprise, and his relentless pursuit of victory was a testament to his unwavering resolve. The Battle of the Bulge, one of the most crucial battles of the war, truly exemplified Patton's strategic acumen. In the dead of winter, with the enemy closing in, Patton managed to rapidly reorient his forces, launching a counteroffensive that broke the German lines and turned the tide of the battle. It was a feat of strategic planning and execution that showcased his remarkable abilities as a leader. Patton's approach to warfare was unorthodox, yet undeniably effective. He believed in the power of relentless attack, of keeping the enemy off balance. His aggressive tactics, combined with his ability to inspire his troops, resulted in some of the most successful campaigns of the war. Patton's leadership in World War II not only contributed to the Allies' victory, but also cemented his legacy as one of America's greatest military leaders. His audacity, his strategic brilliance, and his ability to inspire his troops made him a force to be reckoned with. And his impact on the war, on America, and on the world remains a testament to his enduring legacy. Patton's impact on World War II and the U.S. military cannot be overstated. From his days as a cadet to his tenure as a general, Patton was a force to be reckoned with. He was the embodiment of leadership, courage, and innovation. He spearheaded the development of armor warfare, forever altering the course of military strategy. His major accomplishments, including his pivotal role in the successful invasion of Sicily and the liberation of Germany, are etched in the annals of history, a testament to his strategic brilliance and indomitable spirit. His innovative strategies and tactics continue to inspire military leaders worldwide, shaping modern warfare as we know it. But beyond the battlefield, Patton's legacy lives on in the hearts and minds of those he led. His words continue to inspire, his actions continue to stir admiration. His influence is undeniable, his legend timeless. In the words of Patton himself, "It's not how to die for your country, it's how to make the other poor dumb bastard die for his."